Hi, welcome back. So in this section, we are going to learn the basics of WordPress. And for that, we need to install the WordPress on our domain first. So we have seen how we have hosted our domain. Now we are in the cPanel. Here you can see the web applications option. Here you can see WordPress, Joomla, Drupal, PHPBB, all these content management systems. So we are going to install WordPress. So just click on the WordPress and it will ask you where you want to install the WordPress. So let's see, it is opening. So it will ask you to choose the domain on which you want to install the application. So see here, there is option for install this application. So click on that. Okay. Just click on that to see the next. So we are installing the current WordPress version 4.2.2. So see here, it is showing the domain is yoursuccess.com, which is my domain, and it is asking the optional. What is optional? We can choose the optional, like I want to install WordPress on the this website is already live, so I can't use that. So for that, I'll use / new or / business. Okay, since we are going to install the business web, create the business website, I'll use easyoursuccess.com/business. So see here, this will be the URL for our website. Okay. So if you are using you have not installed anything on your domain, you can leave it blank. So it will be your WordPress will be installed on this directory, but I want to install it in a different directory. So I'm choosing / business. Okay. So after that, you let it be everything. Let it be like that. No need to change anything. Okay. Here you choose your username password. So here you can choose whatever password or username you want. So you choose anything which you want. So I'll choose Sunil and I'll choose some password. Okay. Choose a very strong password and then leave everything as it is. Here you can give the website title. So you can give it here, or we can write letter also. So let it be like this, my blog website name and just another website. Okay, so no need to change now, we can change it anytime. Now click on the install. Okay, when you click on install the WordPress, see here it is processing and it will take some time to install the WordPress. So it is processing. See here, now it is done. It is copying the database tables. So you need not to worry about the database tables or database. Everything will be taken care by the WordPress. So now it is done. We can see the website. So let's open the URL. See here, easyoursuccess.com/business. This is what we have chosen, the URL for our WordPress installation. So see here, now our WordPress basic website is up and running. So see here, it is showing the blog name, WordPress, my blog and subtitle, and here it is showing the sample blog post. Okay, so we can modify this thing. So we can change this and the subtitle as well. So this is how you can install the WordPress. So we have chosen the admin password. To go to the admin panel, we can go to the wp-admin and click on enter. It will ask for the username password. So we have to give the username which we have created during the installation, and we have to enter the password to get the admin access. So I have created Sunil and I have given a password. So I'll click login. So it will take me to the WordPress backend. the WordPress admin dashboard, admin panel. There we can do sort of things. So okay, so it is taking few seconds to get me to the WordPress admin dashboard. So we have to wait for few seconds because I'm online and my internet is bit slow today. It is not always. See here. So this is the WordPress dashboard that we have installed. So this is the dashboard for our new website. Here we can control the WordPress, how our website looks like. So here you can click on the widget website. You can see how your website is looking. So see here. Now we are seeing the website. You can go back to the dashboard from here. So this is the basic dashboard, admin dashboard for the WordPress. So see here, it is so easy to install WordPress in a single click. So we have installed. Now we are seeing the WordPress dashboard, admin dashboard. We'll see all these options in the WordPress basic section, but this is enough to know how we can install. So we have installed the WordPress on our domain. So see you in the next lecture.